The government of Kenya is one of the topics tested at KCP frequently. So for the candidates, you must make sure that you revise very well. So the government of Kenya has three branches or arms of government. The most powerful arm of government is legislature, followed by executive, then judiciary. Legislature is also called parliament. Parliament is divided into two. We have the National Assembly and the Senate. In the Senate, we have senators. The senators are elected at the county to represent the interests of the county at the national level, while members of parliament are elected at the constituency level to represent the interest of the constituency and the whole nation. We have 290 constituencies in Kenya. It means that the elected members of parliament are 290. Apart from that, we have 12 members of parliament nominated by political parties according to their strength in the house. We also have 47 women representatives who are elected at each county. Then we have one ex-official member who is the speaker. The total is 350. These are the total number of who are in the National Assembly. Then we have the Senate. The Senate, as I have said, it has senators. Kenya having 47 counties, we have 47 senators who are elected. These people are elected by the wananchi at the county level. Apart from that, we have 16 women representatives who are nominated by their political parties. Then we have two youth representatives, one female and one male. And then we have two representatives who represent people with disabilities. One should be a male and one should be a female. Then we also have the Speaker of the Senate. The total number is 68. So when you ask in the exams, the total number of people in the Senate, you will say 68 members. Then we have the executive. So executive arm of government is the second powerful arm of the government, which implements the laws. Executive arm of government is chaired by the president himself. It is composed by the president, deputy president, the cabinet secretaries, called CS. We also have attorney general being a member of the executive. We also have the secretary to the cabinet and all other civil servants. For example, when you are talking about the police, we know that they are part of the executive. Why? They maintain law and order. We also have doctors, teachers. These people implement the law. They put into practice. So that is part of the executive. Then we have the judiciary. The judicial arm of government is the third most powerful arm of the government. It is made up by the Chief Justice, who is the president of the courts or the judiciary. It's also made up of the Deputy Chief Justice. Then we also have five members who are the judges of the Supreme Court and any other judge of the superior courts. But you need to understand that judges are part of the judiciary. Then apart from judges, we also have the registrar of the judiciary being a member of the judiciary. And then we have magistrates. They hear cases at the magistrate law courts, which are called subordinate courts. These magistrates work under the superior courts, which are the Supreme Court, the Court of Appeal, and also we have the High Court. Those three courts are called superior courts. Then we have these smaller courts, which are found in the district level, at the county level. Those ones are called subordinate courts. Why? Because they hear cases that are not of high order. So The magistrates are appointed by the Judicial Service Commission, while judges are appointed by the president and approved by the National Assembly. So when we are discussing about the courts, the most powerful court of Kenya is the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court is made up of 7 judges, led by the Chief Justice, Deputy Chief Justice, and the 5 judges of the Supreme Court. It hears cases that are of high order. Then apart from that, the second powerful court in Kenya is the Court of Appeal. Court of Appeal hears some cases from the High Court or other subordinate courts. For example, if somebody has been taken to court and is not satisfied with the decision made, then is able to appeal that case to the Court of Appeal. So Court of Appeal is the one that is the second most powerful court in Kenya. Then the third most powerful court in Kenya is the High Court. It is led by one of the judges who is elected by other judges of that particular court. Then we have other courts called special courts. Special courts are courts that hear a specific case. Namely, we have juvenile court, Kadhi's court, martial court or court martial, and we have industrial court. So juvenile court is also called children's court. It makes sure that children are able to enjoy their rights. Juvenile court is a court that hears how the children are going to be assisted, or if a young person who is involved in criminal cases, it is supposed to hear such cases. Then we have court martial. Court martial is a court that deals with cases from the military. If we have military members who have broken the laws of the military, they are taken to a court by the name court martial. Then we have Kadhi's court. Kadhi's court hears cases from the Muslim community. If they have cases concerning their culture and their tradition, they take the matter into Kadhi's court. Other cases, for example, he has stolen things that belong to other people, he is just taken to criminal court, the normal courts. But if the case is concerning something to do with their culture, they are taken to Kadhi's court. Then we have the last court, which is industrial court. Industrial court hears cases concerning the employer and employee or the workers. So if a worker has any problem and wants it to be solved, then they go to industrial courts. So you'll find that this topic on the government of Kenya, it touches a lot to do with governance. So for example, as I have been explaining on the judiciary as an independent arm of government, it works together with the executive and the legislature to make sure that the country runs smoothly. So if I can go back to the legislature, I said that the legislature is the arm of the government that makes and amends the laws. Apart from making laws, they also determine the expenditure. They are able to make sure that they discuss debates in parliament. They are able to make sure that the interests of the wananchi are met when they are making laws and amending them in the parliament. Then when we are discussing about executive, I said that executive implements the law. It makes sure that it exercises, it executes the law. How? By making sure that whatever that is made in parliament, they are able to practice it. When policemen are doing their work, when teachers are teaching, when doctors are treating, when each and everybody is engaged in day-to-day's work, that is the way we are saying they practice, they implement, or they execute the law. Then the judges are there to make sure that the people get justice and fairness in everything that we do. The main work of the judiciary is to make sure that they interpret the law and there is justice for every Kenyan. Those people who break the law, they are punished. So the judiciary punishes lawbreakers by taking them to court and then rehabilitating them in prisons. They are going to pass sentence according to how serious your case has been. So, as you prepare for your exams, I want to wish you all the best and make sure that you continue working hard and revising for the exam that we can do anytime. I've been your teacher, Teacher Ken. I wish you all the best and see you next time.